Hello friends, welcome back to GK Code Labs. Today I am going to explain very simple yet important topic in Scala, that is tuples. What are tuples in Scala? Tuple is a very simple data structure, but with the help of tuples, you can write many of the complicated problems in Scala and solve it in a very simple way. Also, tuples are asked in most of the interview questions, just to see if your basics of Scala are clear or not. So let's see what are tuples in Scala. So with the basic definition, a tuple is a value that contains a fixed number of elements, each with a distinct type. Also keep in mind that tuples are immutable. A simple demonstration of a tuple can be given like this. We have a fixed number of values, that is a string car and a value 6 lakhs. So just simply separated by a comma and enclosed in brackets, this we can call a tuple. Now let's jump to IntelliJ and see how you can define a tuple and what are the things that you can do with the help of a tuple. I have opened my IntelliJ. Today I am going to work in my local Windows environment because for working on tuples we don't need a big data environment. Let me create a Scala object. Tuples. Okay. Let's define a main class. Now let's see how you can simply define a tuple. I'll initiate a val, let's say tuple 1. Let's take an example as I did show you in that presentation. We can define it like bracket, one string value that is car and one string value that is 6 lakhs. This is as simple as that. Our tuple is defined. Now let's see how you can access these values. You can access these values by the tuple name and the position of the value that you want to access. We can access it like tuple 1 dot, you can see it is already prompting us, underscore 1 stands for first value, underscore 2 stands for second value. So underscore 1, I'll just do a println and let's see what this gives us. And same thing for second value. Let's see what this gives us. So we are getting underscore 1 is car, underscore 2 is 6 lakhs. Okay, now what you will do if you want to assign some variable to the first value and some variable to the second value and you want to access these not with the position but with the variable names. So you can do it like val with the variable name only, you can define a tuple of variable names. That is, let's say product and the price. And we can equate it to the tuple. You can see directly a tuple of variable names will take this tuple if the arguments are matching. Now, tuple 1 is assigned to this tuple of variables. Now product will map to car and price will map to 6 lakhs. Let's try to access this with the variable names. Now in place of tuple 1 underscore 1, we can access it directly with the variable name, that is product. Let's make a string out of it. S stands for making a string. And if you are making a string out of it and you want to access this product inside a string, you can use dollar. Let's say the value of dollar product is dollar price. Let's see what this gives us. You can see the value of car is 6 lakhs. So as you can see, this is very simple data structure to simplify some basic problems. And if you are clear on the syntaxes and the operations that can be done on a tuple, it will be very easy for you to solve problems in simple way and answer those basic interview questions. Let's try to see what else we can do with tuples. So here as of now, we have only one tuple. We can also have a collection like list, sequence, array of tuples. So let's try to create a collection of tuples. And let's see how we can collectively make operations on different values of a list of tuple. So let me define a list, tuple list. This list will have multiple tuples. Let's define car. Let's define some other product like laptop. Laptop is of 60,000, let's suppose. Then we can define a mobile. This is suppose 6000, and one more product, that is a say pen, that is 60 rupees. Okay, so we have a list of tuple here. Now what if you are asked to give similar strings, like the value of product is price for all the tuples in this list. So obviously we have to iterate on this. Let's see how we can iterate on this. So we can write tuple list dot for each, and here we can define a case. Suppose we are getting values like x comma y, that is our product and the price. In such case, where in similar way we can make a string and access the values of first and second element in each array as x and y. So we can write it as the value of dollar x is dollar y. Let's see what this gives us. I'll comment this out. So we are getting everything as expected. Now let's take it one step further. Consider a small use case. If you are given that we have all the products and the prices in a list in form of tuples, and suppose you are asked that after next financial year all the values of the products will face a hike of 10%. Now you are given a list and you have to generate similar kind of output but with the hiked price. So there you have to iterate plus calculate the hiked price of the values of each product. Let's see how we can do that in a very simple way. So iteration will be done in similar way. So I'll copy this. Now the elements are accessed as x and y, so no change here, but we don't have to just print it. So we can make change here. What change? Let's define a new variable, that is hike. So for each tuple, the hike will be calculated as whatever price is there, that is y plus, and if it is 10%, so simple mathematical calculation, that will be 0.1 multiplied by y. So this will give us the hike. After that, we just have to mention a print statement. Println hiked prices after April will be, we can take the product name also here, hiked prices of dollar x, that is our product name, the string, and here the price, that will be our hike, that is dollar hike. Let's see what this gives us. You can see while the second iteration we are getting the new statement with the hiked prices. So this way, with the help of tuple, you can write very simple code snippets and solve your respective problems. Once again, I will tell you, these tuples are very simple but are very important from the interview perspective. So I would suggest you, if you are new to Scala, please practice on tuples and try to solve small problems like this. So thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you liked it. I would request you to subscribe to my channel. It really helps me in staying motivated and make good content for you. Okay guys, then see you in my next video. Take care.